Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Friday Night SmackDown. And there's a reason for that, because he believes, at least he believes in himself, that he's going to beat Brock Lesnar 2 weeks from Sunday at Night of Champions.
Yeah, but is that enough to deal with the beast incarnate? A little positive self-image?
I guess I'm wearing the right color here tonight, aren't I?
The Cornhuskers chant here at the University of Nebraska, go Big Red.
That's all there is to do is watch football here.
For the rest of the world watching, we are at the University of Nebraska tonight. That's why everybody's going tonight. And also for those watching, in 3 weeks at Night of Champions, I will face Brock Lesnar for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. No more talk about if I've changed or if it's best for business. In less than 3 weeks, I will face Brock Lesnar at Night of Champions for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. The match is made. So enough. Stop. Stop talking about if it's right or if it's wrong, if I'm ready or if I'm not, if I can, if I can, if I should, if I shouldn't, stop. I've been here for 12 years, I've had thousands of matches, yet after SummerSlam, all the superstars, including the Authority, Triple H himself, they're looking at me like I'm at the end of my road. They're looking at me like I'm some fragile old man who should just be brought down here to do the Queen's Wave because it's best for business. My name is John Cena. I'm a WWE superstar and I fight. I fight because I want to be the champion. And I want to be the champion because it is the symbol of excellence. And when the day comes, I step my 2 feet in this ring and I don't want to be champion. I turn around, I walk out, and I never come back. Understand, but everyone in the WWE, after this one match at SummerSlam, they don't get it. They do not get it, and it was after one match. Oh, and by the way, one match with the most destructive force that has ever set foot in the WWE, and that's Brock Lesnar. Since 2012, when Brock came back, he has destroyed everything in his path. Brock Lesnar is for real. Brock Lesnar is everything that Paul Heyman says he is and more. And I know Night of Champions will be difficult, but I have my rematch, I find my resolve, and at Night of Champions, I get my redemption. And I don't care if Brock Lesnar's a badass, or Paul Heyman's a loudmouth, or if Ric Flair and Shawn Michaels don't think I have a chance, or if Hogan knows best, or if Triple H can't make a decision, shocker, I will stand right here and say, you line them up and I'll knock them down, and you can still get the WWE Network for $9.99. I'm going to Night of Champions, not just to beat Brock Lesnar. I'm going to Night of Champions to beat Brock Lesnar.
Mr. Money in the Bank, Seth Rollins.
I have to be honest, John, I think you're starting to lose it.
It's like when a 50-year-old guy goes out and he buys like a dozen sports cars. John, are you having a mid-career crisis?
I believe we refer to that as overcompensating.
Oh, look at these guys. Now I'm getting psychological advice from a hell-raised demon who's the brother of a dead guy and now is the poster child for Men's Warehouse. Oh. And you, Mr. Plan B, why don't you kiss my Plan A? The grown-ups are talking. Get on over in the corner and shut up.
Careful, John. You forget that although I may be a competitor, I'm also in a position of power in this company, and I can schedule you for a match right now, which would test your absolute limits. So if I were you, I'd watch my tone.